हेलो डियर लर्नर्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वेलकम टू द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी के जो हमें कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस कोपरगाम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सिलेबस ऑफ योर MSc माइक्रोबायोलॉजी 1 दैट इज गिवन बाय आवर यूनिवर्सिटी सावित्रीबाई फुले पुणे यूनिवर्सिटी। इन दैट आई एम गोइंग टू कंडक्ट योर थर्ड course, that is MB 503, biochemistry and metabolism. So in this video lecture we will discuss about the content or the concept that are included in our syllabus of MB 503 is nothing but biochemistry and metabolism. So let's start the discussion of syllabus. There are generally 4 credits that are included in the course of MB 503. Your first credit or the first unit is protein chemistry. So protein, it is a very renowned and you all are knowing or aware about that. So what is the necessity of protein in the day-to-day life or in the human consumption? So it is very simple that proteins are the building blocks or that are required for the human body as well as for the living cells. So for this purpose we have to study the protein chemistry, like we have to study the basic concept of protein till to the structure. What are the structural criteria, what are the functional criteria of protein in this unit? So let's start one by one. Under the title of protein chemistry there are some subtopics. Like first topic is your structural features of amino acid and classification of amino acids. You already knows that proteins are made up of long chain of polypeptide and it is nothing but the polypeptide chain of amino acid. So for that purpose, what is the basic structure of amino acid, what are the functional group of the amino acids and how they are actually classified on the basis, what is the criteria? So for that purpose we have to study the basic concept of amino acid and how they are classified under the title of classification. So it is very simple, there are 3 general criteria or 3 subtypes of the amino acids. Like they are classified on the basis of non-polar hydrophobic amino acids, second is your polar but uncharged amino acids, and last one is your charged amino acids. So under this title the 20 standard amino acids are classified. After that there are two new standard amino acids are found. First is your selenocysteine, that is 21, and 22nd is your pyrrolysine. So how they classified and what is the concept behind that classification? So we have to study the basic structure and the classification criteria of amino acids in this title. Next one is your amino acid as a buffer, then Henderson and Hasselbalch equation and its role in buffer formulation, peptide linkage, partial bond, nature of peptide bond. So amino acid act as a buffer. Buffer means you know the property of buffer, that is it resists the change in pH. For that purpose the how the amino acid act as a buffer, there is one equation that is given by Henderson and Hasselbalch. And what is the role of buffer formulation by using this equation, we have to study in this particular topic. Peptide linkage and partial bond, nature of amino acid. So what is that? Partial bond nature means there is a partial double bond nature in the amino acid or the protein. So what is that? We have to study in this unit. Next one is your determination of primary structure of polypeptide. in bracket N-terminal, C-terminal determination, method of sequencing peptides. So for the purpose of sequencing or the determination of polypeptide chain in which N-terminal domain, C-terminal domain, how to sequence the particular protein, what are the enzymes required for the sequencing, like trypsinase, pepsinase, chymotrypsinase, carboxypeptidase, aminopeptidase, what is the role of that particular enzymes for the sequencing, what are the different methods that are used for the sequencing, we have to study in this particular unit. Next one is your structural classification of proteins. So proteins are also classified on the basis of structure. They are primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary. For the purpose of classification, primary proteins are very simple, like they are just a long polypeptide chain of amino acids. Secondary structures, like proteins get folding, or proteins are folded, and the folding when get increases, the criteria of structure also get different. Like first is very primary, that is there is simple protein structure, then the proteins get folded due to the modifications of protein, then it will be classified in the secondary structure, then there is a tertiary and quaternary. So these are the structures of protein in which proteins are made up of amino acids. Amino acids are linked by the peptide bond. So what are the different non-covalent interactions are required for the structure of proteins? What are the interactions that are required to make the structures of proteins? We have to study in this particular unit. Conformational properties of protein, polypeptide chain geometry, resonance form of peptide group, cis and trans isomers of peptide group, and Ramachandran plot. These are very important topic that we have to focus on this topic, because the role of Ramachandran plot is very important when there is a criteria of classification of protein. In the secondary structure, there are some helical or the alpha helices structure. Some of them are beta pleated sheets. Some of them they are included turns. Alpha turn, alpha beta gamma turns, beta mendar, Greek key. These are the criteria or super secondary structures that are included in this topic, and we have to study the isomers of the structures or the peptide group in this particular unit. Also that we have to study about secondary, super secondary, motif and domain, tertiary and quaternary structure of proteins, and the example of globular and fibrous protein. Globular protein is your hemoglobin, myoglobin, and fibrous protein is your keratin. Okay, so we are going to discuss these topics, and the another one example of fibrous protein is collagen. So we are going to discuss all this topic in details when we are going to start our first unit, that is protein chemistry. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the next unit, that is biochemistry and molecular biology techniques. So till then, if you have any questions or any doubts related to the topic, you can ask in the comment section. And also, if you have any suggestion, you can ask in the comment section. And one more thing, go through the syllabus, read that once for the proper knowledge of the content and the concept which are included in our syllabus. Thank you.